Hello friends, today I am going to explain you about hardware components of the computer. First, we'll start with switch mode power supply, that is SMPS. This is a device which converts from alternating current to the DC current. We know that computer comprises of different components such as IC, hard disk and CD drives. Usually the ICs, also known as integrated circuit, which works on very low voltages such as 1.2 to 3.3 volt, and hard disk as well as CD drive works on the voltages from 5 volt to 12 volt DC, and these voltages are obtained from the SMPS, that is switch mode power supply. Its main function is to convert from alternating current to the DC current, and this DC current varies from different voltage ranges, that is from 1.2 volt to 12 volt DC. In figure we can see that it takes alternating current and convert to DC current, and that is being provided by these different connectors. Now coming to the central processing unit, also known as microprocessor. This is the brain of the computer. Whenever a user issues an instruction to a computer, and that instruction is performed or taken care by a processor or CPU. Usually CPU consists of two components, that is arithmetic logic unit and control unit. Arithmetic logic unit is responsible to perform all arithmetic and logical operations, whereas control unit control all the devices based on the instruction issued by an user. In figure we can see that this is an example of microprocessor, that is Intel Core i5 and Intel Core i7, and this processor is connected on the motherboard on the ZIF slot, that is zero insertion force slot. This is the microprocessor slot, and we can also see that the microprocessor has heatsink as well as fan. We know that microprocessor is built or created by using millions of transistors, and these transistors generates large amount of heat. In order to dissipate this heat from computer to external environment, we have to use the heatsink as well as fan. Heatsink is an aluminum alloy which transfers the heat from microprocessor body to external environment, and the fan is mounted on the heatsink. It is also helps to dissipate the internal heat of microprocessor to external environment. Motherboard. This is the main board of the computer on which all the components are mounted on it, namely CPU, memory slots, expansion slots and different supporting chips, as well as add-on cards are mounted on this board. And this is a motherboard which consisting of almost all circuitry of the computer. Random access memory. This is type of semiconductor memory. It holds the current use of data of operating system application program. Assume that a user writing a letter using Microsoft Word. Before saving that letter, that data is stored on the RAM, that is random access memory. Once you save that file, that goes and save onto the hard disk. This random access memory is also known as temporary memory or volatile memory. That means the data, whatever stored on the RAM, is going to be deleted once the power goes off. Hence it is known as temporary memory or volatile memory. In figure we can see that this is a RAM, and it is connected on the slot, that is RAM slot. Its name is DIM, that is dual in memory model. Usually the RAM capacity varies from 2 GB, 4 GB and 8 GB. Hard disk is an electromechanical storage device. It usually has larger capacity compared to the RAM. The whatever the data, operating system and application programs, that is going to be stored in the hard disk. Hard disk is a non-volatile device. Here data stores permanently as long as you delete it. In figure we can see that the hard disk can be connected on the motherboard with the help of the SATA cable. that is Serial Advanced Technology Attachment Cable. It is also known as non-volatile device. It means the data is going to store on the hard disk even if the power goes off. If the user want to delete his data, he can delete from the hard disk. Its capacity varies from nowadays to 500 GB to 1 terabytes. Currently, the 16 TB hard disk is also available. Now coming to the DVD, that is a digital versatile disk drive. This drive, it is used to read or write the optical disk such as DVD or CD. Internally, it uses laser light or electromagnetic waves in order to read or write the disks. This sound card is responsible to producing the sound from our computer. Usually, this sound card is connected on the expansion slot, that is PCI slot. Once we connect this card on this PCI slot, after installing its driver, it's going to work and it's going to produce this sound. Now, it has different connectors. Let's see one by one. This yellow connector is used for the loudspeaker. This blue connector is used for external audio sources such as tape recorder, record players, and CD player. Pink connector is used for microphone as well as headphone. Likewise, the green connector is used as sound out or line out connector, which provides the primary sound connection for speaker or headphone. Similarly, the black connector is used for sound out. In this figure, we can see that there is a 15 pin yellow connector, which is used for musical instrument digital interface, that is called MIDI, or it can also be used for the joystick, and this joystick is used when playing the game. Actually, nowadays these sound cards are rarely used because nowadays the motherboard has their own built-in sound cards in order to produce the sound. Now coming to the very important, that is video card or graphics card. This card is used to in order to enhance the capability of the computer. It is very much used for gaming purpose and the graphic development. In the figure, we can see that this video card is connected on the AGP slot. That is AGP slot here is accelerated graphic ports. This port is different from the PCI port. When this card is connected onto the AGP slot and after installing this driver software, its feature can be used. It has three connectors, namely DVI, YesVideo, and VGA. DVI is a digital visual interface. It provides the industry standard for the transfer of digital video content, whereas YesVideo provides the standard definition video, and it's also used for the digital television standard. This type of standards are used in European countries. And this VGA is used to connect a monitor. VGA means video graphics array. Now coming to the last hardware component, that is monitor, keyboard, and the mouse. Monitor is an output device which shows the result on the screen, whereas keyboard, it is input device which is used to enter the data or instruction to the computer. Mouse is a pointing device. These are the components we have discussed in this session. Now it's time to ask few questions to our viewers. Write your answer in the comment section of this channel. What company makes the graphics cards and what company makes the processor? Dear users, hope you like this session. If you like this session, please subscribe, like, comment on my channel. Thank you.